Thank you for watching videos by Jeff Sibelius and landandairphotos.com. The Evo is a great little drone. I love flying it. But in my opinion, it tends to be very aggressive in the way it changes the light metering as your subject matter changes. When you go from light to dark, the exposure changes, and that can really screw up your shot. It's something I refer to as light blooming, where the exposure changes in the middle of your shot. Today I'm going to show you how to use the auto exposure lock function, and with a simple tap on the screen, you can freeze your exposure so it doesn't change in the middle of your shots. Looking at this scene, half of the scene is bright blue sky, and beneath that you have half the scene, which is ground, and then part of that is a very dark body of water, a pond. The camera is being fooled by that bright sky, and so it is underexposing the entire image. Everything is very dark. Now watch what happens when I tilt the camera down. Everything gets brighter. And the reason for that is that the sky is no longer part of the scene. The camera is adjusting for the darker subject matter by brightening up the image to expose. Now watch what happens to the sky as I tilt up. It got darker again. This is what I call light blooming. And this is a problem when you're flying in auto exposure, and in my opinion, particularly when you're flying an Evo. The Evo tends to be very reactive to the lighting conditions as they change in your flight. Well, you want the camera to adjust, and you want to be able to adjust the exposure as you're flying. If you switch over to manual mode, you can manage this by setting a specific shutter speed and ISO, and things won't change. It will lock into that, nothing changes, doesn't matter how good it looks on screen. It doesn't change until you change it. You can accomplish the same basic thing, though, as you're flying in auto mode by tapping on the screen. What I'm going to do is tap on an area of the screen that's not too bright, not the darkest, but somewhere in the middle. And it's down here in the lower corner. See that circle in the lock? Look what happened to the screen. Now we have an average of the brights and the darks in the scene, and we've got a pretty good exposure here. Now, if I were to tap up in the sky, it does it again, and this time it made it too dark because now it's exposing for the sky. Let me tap back down in the bottom corner. And there it is. Now, watch what happens when I tilt down and up this time. As I tilt down, you can see there's no change to the exposure. More importantly, let me tilt up, and you should see no change in the sky. It stayed the same as well. You're going to get a lot better shot in auto exposure mode if you use this auto lock by tapping on the screen. And now I can set it, and let's say I wanted it for the water this time. Now I click on the water, which is the darkest point, and look at how bright the sky is. See all those zebra stripes indicate that the thing is too bright. So if I wanted the water properly exposed, I could do that. So that's all there is to it. Just a tap on the screen, find a middle area in terms of lightness and darkness of your subject matter, pick a middle level spot, tap on it, lock that exposure, and fly with that until your situation changes and you need to reset it. Just tap again and reset it. Thanks for watching. Thank you for watching this video. I set up a Facebook group to make it easier for us to talk and arrange opportunities to fly together. Follow the link in the description below to sign up for the group. On screen, you'll find links to more videos on how to fly drones, so please check them out. Before you go, be sure to hit the like button. Also, subscribe to this channel so you know when more videos are released. Thanks for watching.